Hey everyone, Kyle again from ePoolSupply. Today we are back with Pentair's IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower pool pump. Just want to go over a few things with you guys. Stay tuned. All right, guys, and we're back. So again, today I got Pentair's IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower VSF pool pump. So for those of you guys that aren't familiar, this is the newest model of their 1.5 variable speed pool pump. It does carry the IntelliFlo3 name, so don't confuse it for being a 3-horsepower pump. It is still only a horse and a half pump. It just has that IntelliFlo3 prefix in front of it. So just kind of want to go over a few things with you guys, kind of show you some of the cool features that this pump brings and some of the features that Pentair wants to display to you guys. So just kind of start off, we'll have another video of a comparison compared to the old 1.5 horsepower. So you guys can check that out as well. So that way you guys can kind of see them side by side, but I'll kind of just describe the differences as we go here too. So you'll notice on the front, you guys got a much bigger volute, which is actually nicer comparatively to the old SuperFlo style. This is actually going to allow you guys to get some more debris in there. It's an actual better pump. So I would definitely recommend this one over the older version when you're looking for that horse and a half, just for that front and wet end portion of it. It does still use the same typical unions that the IntelliFlo3 or the SuperFlo uses. I apologize. So it works for both inch and a half and 2-inch pipe. Now, if you're going to go for the bigger version of the IntelliFlo3, which is the 3-horsepower one, those ones actually work for 2 to 2.5-inch pipe. So for those of you guys that actually have that inch and a half pipe and don't actually require that 3-horsepower horsepower for it, I would definitely recommend going with the smaller one just to run a typical suction cleaner on your pool without actually having to tone it way back like the 3-horsepower would do. So same unions. We'll have the links down in the description below for you guys on the parts for all those. I'll actually open up the top here so you guys can see in the basket as well. Much, much heavier duty O-ring. Again, in the comparison video, you guys will get to see them kind of side by side, but a better heavy duty O-ring here to make sure that this pot seals up really well and fills into the water. And then of course you've got your basket. Again, this is gonna look very similar to the SuperFlo basket, but it's a little bit better quality and you can actually make sure that you, again, check the links out below because we'll actually have these available for you guys on the website. So set those up. And then one really, really cool feature about this is you guys will notice it does not have the actual flip top on the back like the predecessor before it. It is actually a fully wireless pump. So you'll see this little antenna on the side. It's really nifty how this thing can actually hook up directly to your Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, how you want to do it. And now you can actually automate the pump without the need of a full panel on your wall. So highly recommend this if you guys just have a real basic system looking to just control something simple like a, like I said, a suction cleaner. Just want to be able to turn the pump on and off in case the storm's coming in. It's really cool that they actually put this in the pump right from the beginning. Again, it's got a nice QR code here on top. You scan it, it walks you through how to do all of this. On top of that, you'll see on the back here that you actually have a zero clearance, which is really nice. So before you'd have to keep some room here for your fan, let your fan cool. So you always had to keep some room between the distance and a wall. With this one, you can actually butt this up directly to a wall. And then underneath here, you'll actually be able to feed up all your power, any of your other connections. They actually have a total of 4 punch outs on one side and then one major one for other power as well on the side. So you get 5 punch outs in the back, which is huge. And then you can actually just run it straight in and then you'll have your connection points here. So like the SuperFlo, this one's really nice that it will also work for both voltages. So you don't actually have to have the 220, 230 voltage. This will also work on the 120 voltage. So depending on what you guys have out there, again, if you don't have a sub panel on your wall, it's really nice that this can actually just still work off of that typical power out there without having to have that high voltage of that 220. So it's really cool. And then you'll notice on the back too, it does have some empty spaces here, which again, we'll get to that in another further video, but I'll let you know that there is another board that you guys can actually attach here onto the pump itself, which actually allows you to control a couple more devices. So it's really cool that they created a base model and then allow you to have all these other opportunities to just kind of piece it together down the road, depending on how you use it. They also give me an opportunity for a touchscreen as well. So again, we'll have another video on that. We'll do an install for you guys and kind of show you what that looks like. But it is really nice to be able to replace this top and put a touchscreen on if you don't really want to have that app control and you want to be able to walk up and just actually do what you want from the pump, they do give you that option as well, but it is an additional purchase. They don't actually want to continue making them with that touchscreen on them. So it just helps overall just to get everybody into that automate age. So if you do happen to get this base model, it will only come with three buttons on here. We've got a connect button for making sure that's actually connected to your phone, connected to your Wi-Fi. That's the connect button's for. It has an on and a stop button just so that you could just turn it on and off if you need to open the basket and clean it. And then they do always give you that nice quick clean feature where you can push it. And it's just a preset feature in the pump where it'll run for a certain amount of time at a higher RPM just to make sure that it gives you that quick clean for your pool. So again, if you want to do any other types of settings or changes, you're going to have to go into the app or you're going to have to purchase that additional touchscreen. So again, just make sure you guys check out the links in the description. We should have all those videos coming to you guys soon on how to do the install for all of that. Also explaining this IO board that sits on the back, but it's kind of what you give you guys a full overhaul and kind of give you an idea of what this IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower is. It is available in two different models. It comes in a 011065, which is your base model that you guys see here. And then you will be able to get the 66 model, which also allows you to have that IO board already included for a little bit of a cheaper price than actually buying it separately. So again, make sure you guys check out below. We're going to have a ton of videos coming your way. Until then, I'm Kyle from ePoolSupply.
Hey guys, thanks for checking out ePoolSupply's YouTube channel. Hit that like and subscribe button down below, and we got new content coming out every single week. Come visit us in store or online at ePoolSupply.com. Thank you.